Hello students, here is first chapter in 12th biology, reproduction in organism. Here we will discuss based on our NCERT syllabus and NEET exam syllabus. In this chapter, different topics are lifespan, reproduction, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Here this chapter explanation is mainly based on NCERT and NEET based syllabus. First we can define what is a reproduction. What is reproduction? You know, reproduction is a biological process in which an organism gives rise to young ones or offsprings similar to itself. See here, this dog gives birth to puppies, not kitten, not cubs. So reproduction is a biological process in which an organism gives rise to young ones similar to itself. That is reproduction. Okay, once again students, reproduction is a biological process in which organism give rise to young ones similar to itself. Very simple definition. Now after birth, you know, there will be a phase of growth. There will be a growth phase that we can call it as juvenile phase in case of animal and vegetative phase in case of plants. Then juvenile phase, after juvenile phase, you know, it goes to reproductive phase. Okay, here you see one seed is germinated. So immediately after birth or germination, plant go to vegetative phase. If it is animal, it go to, that is in juvenile phase. So in juvenile phase, this is the phase of growth. Okay, after their growth, it enters to reproductive growth. Here you see this plant is producing flower, right? So this is reproductive phase. So first phase is juvenile phase, second phase reproductive phase. Okay, second phase it is reproductive phase. This is the phase in which the organism attains reproductive maturity, and the last phase is senescent phase. So there are three phases: juvenile phase, reproductive phase and senescent phase. Okay, senescent phase means that organism loses the ability to reproduction. Last, that lead to the death. Okay, so once again we can define what is juvenile phase. The period of growth in an individual organism after its birth and before reaches reproductive maturity. Okay, so this is a period of growth before attaining reproductive maturity. In case of plants, the juvenile phase is also called a vegetative phase. Okay, in case of plants, it is called a vegetative phase. So the first phase is juvenile phase or vegetative phase, and the second phase, you know, it is the second phase, reproductive phase. In reproductive phase, it is the period when an individual organism reproduces sexually. Okay. And here organism reproduce sexually. That period is reproductive phase. Flower, plants start to produce flowers, for example. Then senescent phase, it is the period when an organism grows old and lost the ability to reproduce. That is called a senescence phase. Organism loses the ability to reproduce. Okay, now you see here is a marigold. This is in which phase? This marigold in which phase, can you tell? Yes, this is in vegetative phase. This marigold is in vegetative phase. Now after this, this enter to next phase. Which is the next phase? Yeah, reproductive phase. Now it start to produce flowers. Okay, this is reproductive phase. And last phase, you see, this is the senescent phase. Okay, so in marigold you see vegetative phase, reproductive phase and senescent phase. You know, marigold lifespan it will live for maximum 1 year, or within 1 year it will complete its life cycle. Such plants are called annuals, and those plants which complete the life cycle within 2 year is called biennials. Okay, so in annuals and biennials you can see clear cut vegetative, reproductive and senescent phase. So in which type of plants we can see clear cut vegetative, reproductive and senescent phase? In annuals and biennials. And here is a mango tree. See, mango tree, you know, it's a perennial plant. What is mean by perennial plant? Because it leaves, it complete its life cycle after more than 2 years. You see, first one vegetative phase, then vegetative phase, then reproductive phase, again it go to vegetative phase. That means in perennial plants it is not easy to identify these phases. Okay, so in perennial plant we cannot clearly differentiate these phases. Okay, it is, so in perennial species it is very difficult to clearly define these phases. Okay, so in annuals and biennials we can clearly define these three phases, but in perennials we cannot clearly define these phases. This is one important NCERT point. Okay, students, next topic, lifespan. You know, every organism from birth to death, there is a time period. That time period, that is called a lifespan. So the period from birth to the natural death of an organism represents its lifespan, and its death should be natural death. Okay, so this is the period from birth to the natural death of an organism. This represents lifespan. You know, students, lifespan, it varies with organism. Okay, next topic, monocarpic plants. See here, monocarpic plants, here is a flower. After vegetative growth it produces flower. This plant after vegetative growth produces flower, then it dies. So here in this plant we see in flowering and fruiting once in their whole lifespan. Okay, that is called a monocarpic plant. Okay, example, annuals and biennials. You know, annuals complete their life cycle within 1 year, biennials complete their life cycle within 2 years. So they are monocarpic plants. Then any perennial plants? Yes, example for perennial plants, they are monocarpic, bamboo and strobilanders. Okay, bamboo flowers only in 50 to 100 years and strobilanders once in 12 years. Next, what is polycarpic plants? Flowering and fruiting takes place many times in their lifespan. Example, most of the perennial plants like a coconut and mango. Students, here is bamboo. Bamboo, you know, is a perennial plant. Even though it is perennial plant, it flowers only once in their lifespan. So they are monocarpic. So usually annuals and biennials are monocarpic. Exception is one of the perennial plant, bamboo, that flowers only once. Students, can you identify these flowers? These are strobilanders, neela kurinji. Okay, strobilanders kundiana, scientific name, strobilanders kundiana. That also flowers only once in their lifespan. Now, already we discussed what is lifespan. It's the period from birth to natural death of an organism that represents its lifespan. Elephant, it is 60 to 90. For the rose, 10 years. Dog, 20 to 30 years. Butterfly, 1 to 2 weeks. Crow, 15 years. Banana tree, 20 to 25 years. Cow, 20 to 25 years. Parrot, 140 years. Students, see, parrot is a small-sized organism compared to cow. Okay, cow is a larger size. Is having larger size, but lifespan is only 20 to 25 years. But in parrot, lifespan is 140 years. See, so size is not related to their lifespan. Okay, then crocodile 60 years, horse 60 years, Fruit fly, 30 days. Rice plant, yes, 4 to 5 months. Tortoise, 100 to 150 years. And banyan tree, 200 to 500 years. Okay, that's lifespan. So students, today we discuss various phases in life, then monocarpic and polycarpic plants, then lifespan. Next class, we will discuss more topic and we will discuss in the part 2, we will discuss more topics and we will discuss board level question and NEET level questions.